I want to cover day parting today and scale insights. Everyone that's following us now knows we use scale insights and data dive. And that's it. And that's what's great is I know the audience, like I know Brandon Young's audience as he trains you guys on scale insights. So hopefully you can keep getting these golden nuggets on how we're using these tools together to constantly optimize our clients' accounts. Day parting. Day parting is a much more advanced PPC topic that if you're a smaller seller, you probably have heard about it, but maybe not messed around with it. Simplest way to explain it is day parting is changing your campaigns based on the day of the week or based on the hour of the day. And I want to give a caveat here is changing ads based on the hour of the day requires a lot of attention and a lot of automation. So I'm going to be very honest. Right now, we're only day parting days of the week, okay? I know that Amazon came out with some new features, even in their own platform, that is giving much more accurate hourly data. And we're messing around with it in some spots, but for now and for argument's sake, I'm gonna be talking about days of the week, how some days of the week perform better than others. And Scale Insights makes this super easy, okay? So, Scale Insights here, if you go to sales, trends, orders, and returns, right? On the main screen, day parting trend, boom, it's right there. So I'm going to ignore hourly right now, just because I think day of the week is easier to think about this. And if you're not day parting, you wanna start with just days of the week. So I go to day of week sales, right away, boom. So I can tell you already day parting weekends on this account, okay? So what you want to look at when you come in here is obviously average sales, right? So we can see Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, very strong for this account. So Friday, we're not day parting. Friday, we keep ads running. And you can see Friday, and we have 4 weeks selected here. You can choose a bigger date range, 4 weeks selected. Friday is significantly lower than the other weekdays. And then Saturday and Sunday, we bring it down. Now, why do we do this? Is a lot of this is driven by conversion rate, okay? So we can see that Saturday does still convert well, but Sunday converts at 10%, which is 2 to 3% lower than the rest of the week, okay? So we talked with the owner, and we said we decided for now, we do want to try this is lowering down spend on Saturday and Sunday, okay? And the coolest thing is that, so profits here for this used to be way lower. And let's see if I can pull those up for a previous date range. Okay, so when I go back a few months, again, it's August now, it's about late August. If I go back to May, so May 17th, and I do 4 weeks of data, Saturday had a 17% profit margin. The rest of the week, and Sunday as well, 16 and 17%. The rest of the week had 21, 22% profit margin. If I now go, since we've started day parting, go to August, again, 4 weeks of data, day of week sales. The margin has increased for Saturday and Sunday. It's gotten way, way, way better. And now it's actually better than some of the other days of the week. Well, because we're spending less. But before, there was such a disconnect and we were losing money on those days in some cases, okay? So if you have that big of a disconnect, as you should see, you want this to be even out the whole week, right? And now Friday is actually lowest profit margin because we haven't started day parting that yet. Okay, so that's just a quick breakdown of if you come in here and see that certain days of the week have a much lower profit margin, and that could be killing your whole profit margin for the month, for the year. Those are the days of the week you want to slow down. So now if I come over here and we want to go to automation, and then I'm going to show you very simply how to set this up. We go to automation and algorithms day parting rule, okay? So now you can come in here and look at day parting rules. We always like to name our day parting rules and we go NZ weekends off, okay? Now, first off, I want to call out Luke Lim, the owner of Scale Insights. Because he does a great job in the tool of giving great tutorials We're just here to kind of make videos to kind of go off of his step-by-step tutorials. So if you're in that dayparting rule, open that up, and Luke has done a really, really good job of showing you what to look for, and he does this by hour, okay? So he's showing you. You guys can walk through this yourself. I'm not going to go through this step-by-step because I'm hoping I can make the video a little easier for you. He does it by hourly, okay? So if you want to mess with this, and that very first screen of the Scale Insights was hourly sales. So that's what he's diving into here. I'm diving into day of week sales, and he shows you how to set it up. Now, to set this up, all you're going to do, create rule. And this is how simple the layout is. It gives you hour of the day, day of the week. Okay. So for our weekends off rule, we're unchecking all of these boxes for Saturday and Sunday. I'm not going to do this live. We're unchecking every single box for Saturday and Sunday, hitting create. Okay. Then all you do is you come back here and you choose which one of your ad groups you want to be put into that rule. Okay. So you do this, you select your dayparting rule, NC weekends off. You choose your ad groups, you put them in there, you enable them, boom, you're off and running. Okay. Now, all I can say here for a recommendation is maybe don't do this for a whole account right away. Okay. Is if you see, again, that profit margin that is very low on the weekends or maybe on a Friday, daypart some of your big campaigns to start, some of your ad groups, right? And try that for a couple of weekends. Before you do it, your whole account, take your two biggest campaigns that spend a lot and maybe lower them for one day, okay? And then it'll turn it back on in the week, during the week, and you can see week over week, okay, are my sales at least staying the same, or is this completely killing me? Then you probably won't be able to do dayparting, because the last thing you want is to daypart and to lose your ranking, right? If you can't maintain that rank, then you probably can't daypart. But I really hope that this helped. It's easier than you think, and Scale Insights makes it very easy. So create a daypart rule, try either the weekends or one day of the week, and see if that helps you with your profit margin and growth for your brand.